Now discuss the topic is known as development of dicot embryo. The stages involved in the development of dicot embryo: capsella, bursa pastoris. The embryo developed at microphyllar end of embryo sac. The zygote undergoes transverse division to form upper and terminal cell, the lower or basal cell. Further division in the zygote during the development lead to the formation of the embryo. Embryo undergoes globular and heart-shaped stages before reaching a mature stage. The mature embryo has a radical and two cotyledon and a plumule, etc., etc. So this is the development of embryo, different type of stages. A diagram show the zygote, B diagram show the zygote is divided into two-celled pro-embryo. C diagram show that the two-celled pro-embryo is divided into four-celled pro-embryo. D diagram show that four-celled pro-embryo is converted into globular embryo. And F diagram, the embryo is heart-shaped. G diagram, the mature embryo. H diagram, mature embryo in a seed. Seed, the fertilized ovule is called seed and possesses an embryo and endosperm and a productive coat. The productive coat is called, outer coat is called testa and inner coat is called tegumen. The seed may be endospermous, wheat, maize and barley and sunflower, or non-endospermous, bean, mango and orchid and cucurbits. Structure of a sizer seed, an example for dicot seed. The mature seed are attached to the fruit wall by a stalk is called funicles. The funiculus disappear, leaving a scar is called hilum. Below the hilum, a small pore is called microphyll is present. The microphyll is a small opening. It is used for the exchange of the gases and uptaking of the water. It facilitates the entry of the oxygen and water into the seed during the germination. Each seed has a thick outer covering called seed coat. The seed coat is developed from the integument. You are already studying in the structure of ovule. Ovule is covered by two integument, outer integument and inner integument. So outer integument is converted into testa and inner integument converted into tegumen. The outer coat is called testa and it is hard, whereas the inner coat is called thin, membranous, and it is called tegumen. In pea plant, the tegumen and testa are fused. Two cotyledon laterally attached to the embryonic axis are present. It stores the food material in pea, whereas in other seed like castor and endosperm contain reserve food and the cotyledon are thin. The portion of the embryonal axis projecting beyond the cotyledon is called radical or embryonic root. The other end of the axis is called embryonic shoot, is a plumule. Embryonal axis above the level of the cotyledon is called epicotyl, whereas the cylindrical region between the level of the cotyledon is called hypocotyl. The epicotyl terminates in plumule, whereas the hypocotyl end in radical. This is the structure of the dicot seed, full structure and seed cut opened. Structure of oryza seed, it is example for monocot. The seed of paddy is one-seeded, it is called caryopsis. It is actually fruit, is not a seed. Each seed remain enclosed by a brownish husk, which consisting of gloom, arranged in two rows. The seed coat is a brownish membranous layer, closely adhered to the grain. Endosperm form the bulk of the grain and in the storage tissue. It is separated from embryo by a definite layer called epithelium. The embryo is small and consisting of one shield shaped cotyledon is known as scutellum. Present towards the lateral side of the embryonal axis, a short axis with the plumule and radical protected by the root cap is present. The plumule is surrounded by a protective sheath is called coleoptile. The radical including root cap is also covered by a protective sheath is called coleorhiza. The scutellum supply the growing embryo with food material absorbed from the endosperm with the help of the epithelium. This is the structure of the monocot seed, example paddy. Apomixis. Reproduction involving fertilization in flowering plant is called ambimixis. Ambi means two. I mean male gamete and female gamete involving reproduction is known as ambimixis. Wherever reproduction do is not involve, union of male and female gamete is called apomixis. Apomixis la reproduction involve agadhu, ambimixis la reproduction involve agum. The term apomixis was introduced by Winkler in the year 1908. It is defined as a substitution of the usual sexual system, ambimixis, by a form of reproduction which do is not involve meiosis and syngamy. Meiosis and syngamy rendume nadandhaadhaan adu vandu true fertilization, true reproduction. So apomixis la meiosis and syngamy is totally absent, so they are known as apomixis. Maheshwari 1950 classified apomixis into two type, recurrent and non-recurrent. Recurrent apomixis, it included vegetative reproduction and agamospermy. Non-recurrent apomixis, haploid embryo sac developed after meiosis, develop into a embryo without fertilization. Recurrent apomixis is classified into two type. First one is known as vegetative reproduction. Second one is known as agamospermy. Agamospermy is classified into three type, adventitious embryoni, diplospory, apospory. Vegetative reproduction, plant propagate by any part other than seed, bulbil, fritillaria, imberiliasis, bulb, allium, runner, mentha, arvensis, sucker, chrysanthemum. Agamospermy, it refers to the processes by which embryo are formed, by which eliminating meiosis and syngamy is called agamospermy. Adventitious embryoni, an embryo arises directly from the diploid sporophytic cell, either from nucellus or integument. It is called sporophytic budding because gametophytic phase is completely absent. Adventitious embryo are found in citrus and mangifera. Diplospory, generative apospory. A diploid embryo sac is formed from the megaspore mother cell without a regular meiotic division. Example, Eupatorium and Arva. Apospory, megaspore mother cell undergoes the normal meiosis and four megaspore formed gradually disappear. A nuclear cell become activated and developed into a diploid embryo sac. This type of apospory is called somatic apospory. Example, Hieracium and Parthenium. Let's now discuss about the new topic is known as polyembryony. Occurrence of more than one embryo in a seed is called polyembryony. Normally one seed appadinave one seed kulla oru embryo dhaan irukanum, adu normal seed, but one seed kulla vandu many embryo irundhuchu appadina they are known as polyembryony. The first case of polyembryony was reported in Chatain Orange by Anton von Leeuwenhoek in the year 1719. Polyembryony is divided into four categories based on its origin. First one, cleavage polyembryony, example orchids. Second one, formation of embryo by cells of the embryo sac other than egg. Synergid, Aristolochia, antipodal cell, ulmus and endosperm, Balanophora. Third one, development of more than one embryo sac within the same ovule. Derivatives of same megaspore, monosporic megaspore cell, derivatives of two or more MMC, Casuarina. D, activation of some sporophytic cell of the ovule, nucellus or integument in citrus and zygium. Practical application of the polyembryony. The seedlings are formed from the nucellar tissue. In citrus are found better clones for orchids. Embryo derived through polyembryony are found viral free. The diagram showing the polyembryony. The zygote contain embryo and antipodal cell contain embryo. So occurrence of more embryo in one embryo sac. Parthenocarpic fruit. As mentioned earlier, the ovary become the fruit and the ovule become the seed after fertilization. However, in number of cases, the fruit-like structure may be developed from the ovary without the act of the fertilization. Such fruit is known as parthenocarpic fruit. It is otherwise known as seedless fruit. Abdin mentioned pondra. Invariably, they will not have true seed. Many commercial fruit are many.